Hello everyone, and thank you for watching another video. It's V or Stoner V, whichever video you watch, you know? But it's been a while. Yeah, it's been a while since I made a video. And reason is because I moved from California to Oklahoma. So having to get home and just get back into the groove. So finally we're finally been able to call this place home and been able to get back into the groove so I can make more videos. And on this video, it's part of a blog that I wrote for myzenovitz.com, a weekly blog that I do. So, and on that blog, I talked about eucalyptus this week and how, it could be brought into your life and used for more daily life. You know, because I brought it more, that I use it more and it's helped me. So I wanted to bring it to you and show you some home remedies that you're probably going, whoa, I remember my grandma using that on me. But before I give you some remedies, I want to talk a little bit about the history of eucalyptus. A little bit of history about eucalyptus. One little fact about eucalyptus is that it takes up 3/4 of the vegetation in Australia. And there's like 600 species of them. Along with that, there's other countries that have eucalyptus. It's mostly in the region where it's warm and everything. There's some in Africa, but there's some in the Philippines. And also we had some brought to us in the US and North America. And it was brought to California. It was brought to California during the gold rush. I believe it was in 1880. They brought the eucalyptus. And I guess, they brought it over here and they said it grows pretty fast and it grows tall. Some trees can grow as tall as 200 feet. The redwoods, I believe, the tallest tree. So it's up close to the redwoods. So they brought them over and they were easy to crop. So they had started crop in California because that's when the railroad was being built. So when the railroad was being built, they needed something that was, I believe, going to grow fast and they can just use it. So when they started growing them in California and they cut them and then they let them dry and they had them all out there and they realized that once it dried, it twisted, the wood would twist. Not only did it twist, but whenever they were trying to poke, drill those stakes into it, it wouldn't go in. They were so hard, so they couldn't use them. So that's how it was brought to the US. And so they decide, they just plant them all over the area. The reason it grows really well in California, because it stays really warm over there. And you don't have a lot of winter. I mean, I lived there for 5 years and I felt like I never had a winter. You may have a couple of days that are really cold, but that's why eucalyptus can grow in that area. It probably can grow in other areas, but more known here in the US, it's grown there. But most all the eucalyptus is mostly in Australia because it takes up 3/4 of their country. Now that I've given you a few tips about it, I'm going to talk about some of the healing powers of how it can help you in your daily life. There's several ways on how it can help you. But first, before I do that, I'm going to go get our next thing ready, because I'm going to show you how you can use it whenever you have a cold. So stay tuned. I'll be right back. Hi, everyone. I just had to go heat up some water because you can see the vapors coming up. You need those vapors, because what I'm about to show you, it might remind you of something that your grandma used to do. Yeah, or maybe she had you do when you were a kid and you're like, you may have forgotten, or you may still use this. But what it is you make sure that you get a good bowl and put some boiling hot water. Hot enough where your steam lasts for at least 10 to 15 minutes. And what you want to do is you want to add some eucalyptus oils into it. And you probably add about desired from 5 to 10 drops, even more if you feel like you're congested. Because what this is going to do, it's going to help your congested sinuses. It's going to help you breathe better. It's going to open up those lungs. So what the one thing that you want to do is that you want to put your face at least about this far up, and you want to use a towel that's able to cover you up, so that way you're able to stay under here. Because you know those days when we just forget how to take care of ourselves, like those days when you're feeling like poo, try this and you'll be like, whoa, I can breathe. Because most of the time, I know when I'm sick, I forget how to take care of myself. And my wife reminds me, oh yeah, we should try this because you told me about this. So yeah, try this out. So whenever you're feeling that you can't breathe, or you have asthma, or you just feel like you have the cold or the flu, this should help relieve your congestion. Is what you do is you lift, you know, the blanket, and you go right under here. And you breathe in the vapors. And you go in as close as you like, you know, and then you're gonna also feel like it's gonna give you a facial. So it's gonna open up the pores. And then just sit here and just breathe it in. And one thing that's also, this would also be good for, is eucalyptus is known for a mental drainage. You know, you have mental drainage, you've been at work, and you're just really just tired, that they just mentally drained you, you know? I know those because I used to be a drafter, and sometimes I come home, I just couldn't take anything. I couldn't even get in the computer because I was at the computer all day and just couldn't see anything else. So maybe you feel that way where you can't take no more information, you just can't do it anymore. Try this, because this is gonna uplift you, it's gonna bring you, it's gonna make you feel better, and it's gonna help you. You know, it's gonna help you feel a little better mentally. Nice. And then be drained, you're gonna go, wow. So try this out, and it'll uplift you. Another thing that eucalyptus is good for, it's good for a pain reliever. Now the way you can use that as a pain reliever is I wouldn't suggest to be putting the oil and just rubbing on under, because it's concentrated. So we have to make like a balm, or use Vicks. You know, if you don't want to make a homemade balm, because it only takes 3 ingredients to make a homemade balm. You can buy them at your health foods place. And that is, you know, medical grade coconut oil. You can buy that where the products for the shampoo and all that is. In a health food store, they'll have some, you know, coconut oil that you can use for products that you make at home. Then you can use beeswax, or have that in that area. And you'll add shea butter. Yeah, shea butter. You put shea butter in there and you mix those three up. You know how you make chocolate? You know how chocolate's made? They put a pan and they put water in and they put a bowl and then they mix it all up and keep it there till it melts. That's the same way that you would make a bomb. And you sit there till it melts. And once it melts, you turn off the heat and then you add some oils as your desired. For a bomb, I would probably put at least 10-15 for the jar. You know, 10-15 drops for the jar that you're gonna have. And the jar that you use, make sure that you use a UV protected. Because if you notice, these jars have UV, because sun shouldn't be getting to these oils, because then they just won't work after, once the sun hits it, it just doesn't work. You know, it doesn't stay, it doesn't last a long time. So it's best to put, you know, use it in a UV protected product. So they sell that at a health food store too. Now what you do is, once it dries, you know, you can use that balm, just get in there and just use it. And then if you get a burn, I got a burn one time and I burned myself with the rig. And I actually took, if you don't know what a rig is, it's, never mind. But I burned myself with a rig. I'm very klutzy at times. And I burned myself right around here. You can't even tell if you see it. So I'm gonna leave some pictures at the end of how I remembered that I had eucalyptus in my balm. And I was like, oh, that's good for burns and for cuts and wounds. And because also pain reliever, and it was hurting. I was like, okay, I'll try it. And I put it instantly and it felt so good. I mean, it didn't hurt as much as what it would do with and other, you know, stuff that I use. They tell you use mustard when you get burnt. Dude, that hurts. It seems like I can't use mustard, but I used that and it helped tremendously. I'll leave video, like I said, I'll leave pictures at the end. But yeah, you can put this in the balm. You can make this balm. Whenever you burn yourself, you can rub it on there. Then the other thing you can use that balm for is if you have like an, let's just say you scraped yourself from running, or your child, they went out and rode their bike and they come home and they come with a scrape. Now, another thing about eucalyptus, it kills bacteria. So if you put that balm on there after, if you don't think that it's enough, put that other stuff, you know, the stuff that comes in the jar, I can't remember what it's called, antibacterial type stuff that you get in a first aid, you can use that, and you can, or if you feel like you can add this to it, like to the to that, you know, put some of this eucalyptus onto it, and it's gonna heal it up, right? It's also gonna kill that bacteria, and it's gonna help heal that cut much faster. So, and I probably would wait maybe a day or so, or if you feel, because sometimes when you put these, it might, I don't think it burns. It didn't burn me whenever I put it on my burn, but I don't know how it does for a cut. I put it on my scrapes and it doesn't burn me, but for a child, if you decide to use this balm on a child, use very little, because it's not recommended for children to use a lot of oils or direct oils, because of they can't, their immune system is a lot, you know, less than ours. And that's what we get in adults, we're used to stuff, you know? So yeah, so now you can use it for cuts, for scrapes, and for when you have the flu and stuff like that. So hopefully these methods helped you. I know a lot more on how eucalyptus can help you. If you would like more tips, because I could just go on and just talk forever, but if you would like more tips on eucalyptus, hit like and let me know in the comment area. And let me know, hey, I like more tips on eucalyptus. How much more? I got lots more, so let me know. All right, guys. Now, I'm pretty sure I talked your ear out. So I'm gonna end it right here. And I'm gonna say thank you for everybody that's watching, and hopefully this has helped you, how you can bring, you know, eucalyptus into your life and help you breathe a lot easier and better and everything. So, all right, guys. All right, till the next video. Read my blog on zenevents.com, weekly blog. I don't know if I'll do a weekly video on it, I'll try. If so, hey, keep subscribe and you'll get posted. All right, guys, bye-bye.